I got the opportunity to work on research early in my junior years, and I felt like I got a great basic understanding of research, and I wanted to do more in the translational and basic science realm. And I knew that there was a lot going on in terms of genomic research in New York at the Memorial Sloan Kettering Hospital. And fortunately, our faculty members are well connected across the country with other big players at different institutions, so it was very easy to set up a relationship and a communication with faculty at MSK, and I was able to get an opportunity secured there for my research time. There were a couple things I focused on. So my main focus was looking at genomic correlates for tumor biology. So how can we better select patients for certain interventions, whether they may be surgery upfront or certain types of chemotherapy, either systemic chemotherapy or locally given chemotherapy in the liver for colorectal liver metastases, for example. And if we could find genomic markers for which patients would do better with upfront chemotherapy versus going for surgery first, and if there are any differences in terms of what these genomic markers could portend over time, especially in different cohorts, for example, initially unresectable patients that could become resectable if they were given chemotherapy, or even differences based on age group. If there are different genomic markers in young patients that develop colorectal liver metastases, younger than the age that we recommend surveillance colonoscopy for, versus those that are older that should be getting surveillance colonoscopies. And we were looking at whether there was a difference in the genomic biology of the cancer that arose. Like a lot of medical students, I came into surgical residency very interested in trauma because I got maybe a disproportionate experience of operative trauma, sick patients in the ICU that we got better because my residents wanted me to make sure I went where the action was, so I wanted to be wherever trauma was, and I thought that would be what I'd want to do. But over time, when I came here as a resident, I recognized that the procedure classes and the patients that went through the surgical oncology service were more interesting to me and spoke to the specific things that I wanted to work with. You have a longer relationship with patients over time as you're following them, either as a pre-op or a post-op surveillance sort of relationship. And also you have the opportunity to take them from somewhere where they're very concerned and very upset about a certain diagnosis to get them to the point where you can tell them that we don't have any disease anymore and that we may have effectively cured you, or if you haven't, be there with them through the process so that you can make sure that they're doing well. And I thought that that opportunity to have a long relationship was something that was more interesting to me. And being here, you had the opportunity to look at a trauma service where you took care of patients as you would at many institutions that had high volume trauma, penetrating or blunt trauma, gave me an adequate experience there that I felt like I had a good exposure to what real trauma would be like no matter where I went. And so I could make a decision based on seeing that versus surgical oncology, knowing that what I saw in surgical oncology truly was more interesting and spoke to more of what I wanted my practice to be like. So once I figured out the specialty that I was most intellectually interested in, I was trying to figure out how I can get the skill set that would make me an effective surgeon over time. Clearly, we get that training here at Stanford because you have the clinical training, you get the technical training because we have some of the highest volume pancreatectomy cases residents log across the country. But the next thing was trying to figure out what the right research opportunity would be for me. So, just like most residents, I was trying to find an opportunity here at Stanford, but from talking to more and more of the faculty, they were very upfront with me and said, what you specifically are interested in can be obtained at a different institution. And they were very supportive of me leaving Stanford for a certain period of time to go there and get that training, to come back and then offer it to the junior residents here, the trainees here, and to help have that skill set be a part of me as I go forward in my training. And when you're a junior resident and you're you really get a good perspective of how the post-operative care of patients vary depending on what happens in the operating room or what is done to help optimize patients before surgery. But when you're looking at it from a research perspective, you have a more global perspective of what can we do to optimize patients before they even get to the operating room, or why did we select this patient versus that patient to go for surgery. So doing more reading, looking at a larger data set, gave me more of a global understanding of what it means to select patients for certain interventions. And it's tough to get that experience as a junior resident. So it kind of put more into perspective the people that made it to the operating room were a very well-selected group, and that kind of helped put into perspective where you thought folks would go over time and what your expectations should be and how you should temper them based on whether this is somebody that you have worked on for a couple of months with chemotherapy and got them to the point that you can provide an operation for them, versus if someone shows up very sick and they have a tumor that looks identical to another person that may have gotten chemotherapy beforehand, but a sick person going for the same operation has a very different outcome than someone that's been well selected, treated with chemotherapy over time, and then made it to the operating room. So it really does change your global perspective. And in addition to that, just having the opportunity to read more, learn more about what's up and coming, and knowing that when we're doing something here at Stanford that may be done differently elsewhere, trying to understand the differences and to ask higher level questions that get you on a better understanding of what would be up next and like cutting edge when you're trying to build your own practice in the future to decide what you want to do for yourself. That sort of global experience, I think, was very helpful to identify that. I guess one of the great things about Stanford is that it has a lot of opportunities for people that are looking to work in a variety of research settings here locally. But if you're truly interested in getting a skill set that the faculty understand is not available here, they will be honest with you and they will let you know that it's not available here, but we know where you can get it. And they will be fully supportive of you going there to obtain that skill set, with the understanding that you'll bring it back and teach other trainees how to use it.